Hello all, welcome to the playlist of Basic Electrical Engineering. In this session, I'll be discussing what do we mean by root mean square value, or we can call it as RMS value. So I'm damn sure that by the end of the video, you will understand what is an RMS value and what is a simple expression for RMS value. Let's get started the discussion on RMS value. First of all, you have to consider two circuits. Circuit number one. We are having a simple resistor which is connected to AC supply. Circuit number two, another resistor you are supposed to connect another DC source. One circuit is actually AC circuit, other will be DC circuit. And circuit number one, it is purely AC circuit. Circuit number two will be DC circuit. And you will be passing the current. Whenever you provided the supply, definitely current is going to flow through the circuit. Now let us come to the definition. The root mean square value, or you can call it as RMS value, is defined as the steady state current which is flowing through given circuit for a given time produces the same heat as produced by the alternating current when flowing through the same circuit for the same time. As I just discussed, there are two circuits. The first circuit is purely AC. This is a resistive load. Here AC current is going to flow. Now let us consider circuit number 2. Here we have to consider a DC circuit. Let us say a battery. That means it's a DC circuit. So a current will be passing through in that particular resistive element. Now the equivalent value, we can call it as it is basically a steady state current or DC current flowing through a given circuit for a given time produces the same amount of heat, H is equal to I square RT, same amount of heat as produced by the alternating current when flowing through the same circuit for the same time. So the equivalent value, we can call it as RMS value. Okay, so equivalent, by considering DC and AC quantity, we can able to say that it's an RMS quantity, or it is also known as effective value or virtual value of AC. So this is regarding the definition of RMS value. First of all, you have to consider the circuit diagram which is shown over there. There is a waveform. So this is actually, we can call it as AC waveform, and this will be purely DC waveform. In case of AC waveform, you can able to say it is varying with respect to time, and in case of DC, it never changes with respect to time. And also we have to identify the equivalent value, or we can call it as RMS value, corresponding to AC circuit and DC circuit. Here we can say that the value of current I, we can able to write it as I is equal to, I will be Im sin theta. Im sin theta. It is very true. Here we can able to say that d theta is the thickness. We can call d theta. It is the thickness. You can note on this. And I square is the mid-ordinate. As you can able to see, the I square is the mid-ordinate. So I square, it is the mid-ordinate. We can able to write I square is the mid-ordinate. So we can able to write I square is equal to, what we can write? I square is equal to Im sin theta the whole square. You can able to write in this manner. You need to consider the area of the strip. Here you can able to see. Consider the small strip, will consider as the shape of a rectangle. So we are supposed to approximate it as a rectangle. So what could be the area? Area of the strip. So area of the strip is equal to, area of the strip is equal to length into breadth. Here length we can consider. What is the length? Length will be I square. Correct, no? I square. Length will be I square. And breadth will be d theta. So you can able to elaborate. Okay, I square means Im sin theta the whole square. We can write it as Im square sin square theta into d theta. This will be the area of the corresponding strip. But I need to calculate entire area. How I can able to calculate? the area of the first half cycle I have to consider. From 0 to pi I have to consider. So area of the first half cycle, that is equal to, so I'll be writing area of first half cycle. Okay, area of first half cycle is equal to, so integral, you can do the integration, you can start doing the integration. Integral 0 to pi, lower limit is 0, upper limit is pi. Now we can substitute im square sin square theta d theta. Here do one thing, im square can be taken outside. Im square, so what I can write, 0 to pi sin square theta d theta. So there is no standard form of integral of sin square theta, so sin square theta can be written as sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So in spite of sin square theta, you can able to write 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. So let me rewrite. Integral 0 to pi. Here im square will be the, okay, it's a constant, instantaneous value, peak value. So 1 minus cos 2 theta. 1 minus cos 2 theta. Divided by 2 d theta with respect to theta. So do the integration. So it could be, so 2 can be taken outside. Im square by 2 into integral 0 to pi 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. 1 minus cos 2 theta d theta. So further integration, so we can able to give im square by 2 into im square by 2 into, so integration of 1 theta means theta minus, this will be sin 2 theta by 2, sin 2 theta divided by 2. Don't forget to give the limit 0 to pi. Now we can give the value. What could be the value? This become im square by 2 into, give the value pi. Instead of theta we can give pi minus sin 2 pi by 2 means 0, correct? 0 minus lower limit, you can give 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0. So this become, how much it becomes, pi im square by 2, pi into im square by 2. Now I wanted to calculate the RMS quantity. So the RMS quantity is equal to, I is equal to again able to write the formula, I is equal to area of the first half cycle of the wave divided by base. What is the area? We computed pi im square, correct? Pi im square divided by, what is the base? Pi im square by 2 divided by, base will be pi only, correct? So if I simplify, I'll be getting square root of im square by 2. Im square by 2. That is equal to im by root 2. So I can write irms equal to im by root 2. Similarly, we can able to write vrms equal to vm by root 2. Okay, so rms value is equal to, we can write irms equal to im by root 2. Similarly, vrms can be written as vm by root 2. So this is the way how to make out the RMS quantity. See, same thing I have done here. You can go through that. IRMS equal to IM by root 2. Or else you can write 0.707 IM. ERMS equal to 0.70 IM. So this is actually the RMS.